From the Armenia TV studios in Yerevan, I'm Paul Chaderjian.
And I'm Rubina Margosyan, and here are the headlines at this hour.
The Richard Hoagland saga continues on Capitol Hill. One New Jersey senator is putting a stop to the nomination.
The Yerevan Brandy Company inks more deals with grape producers.
And the Prime Minister checks out Armenia's new airport terminal.
These stories and more right now on Armenia TV. U.S. Senator Robert Menendez has placed a hold on the confirmation vote on the candidacy of Richard Hoagland as the next U.S. ambassador to Armenia.
Senator Menendez, who is a Democrat from New Jersey, says he is opposed to the vote because the Bush administration refuses to recognize the Armenian genocide.
In blocking the Hoagland nomination, Senator Menendez stressed that as a leader and defender of democracy, it is the responsibility of the U.S. to speak out against injustice and support equality and human rights. The senator says if the Bush administration continues to refuse to acknowledge the atrocities of the Armenian genocide, then there is certainly cause for great alarm, which is why he is placing a hold on the Hoagland nomination. On September 7th, after more than 40 minutes of intense debate, the Senate Foreign Relations Committee approved Ambassador-designate Hoagland's nomination. The committee's concerns included Hoagland's written responses to California Senator Barbara Boxer's inquiry, in which Hoagland questioned whether the Ottoman Turkish government intended to commit genocide or not. Other committee members were concerned with the State Department's firing of the current U.S. ambassador to Armenia, John Marshall Evans. Evans' early recall from Yerevan is widely seen as retribution for his public statements in February of 2005, calling for an end to word games by the U.S. government in avoiding the proper recognition of the Armenian genocide. Despite dozens of congressional inquiries, the administration has yet to explain its reasons for firing Ambassador Evans or to reveal the communications it received from Turkish officials on this matter.
President Robert Kocharyan's press office is not ruling out the possibility that Kocharyan may meet with his Azeri counterpart Ilham Aliyev in Minsk next month. The meeting may take place on October 17th during the CIS summit. The meeting hinges on the successes of Armenia's and Azerbaijani's foreign ministers' meetings with OSCE Minsk Group co-chairs this week in Paris and London.
Armenian Foreign Minister Vartan Oskanyan is back from Paris, where organizers of the Year of Armenia in France announced more than 500 cultural events taking place in France to celebrate Armenian culture. Upon his return, the Foreign Minister and Prime Minister Andranik Markaryan toured the new arrivals terminal at the Zvartnots International Airport.
12,000 meters squares, a capacity to handle 2 million passengers, 12 migration posts, as well as a 110-meter-long luggage table able to handle 4 flights simultaneously, are just a few of the features of the new terminal of the Zvartnots Airport, which is now nothing less than other modern international airports. After a tour of the new terminal, Prime Minister Andranik Markaryan evaluated the airport as excellent and said that the invested funds were not a waste, adding that the terminal was constructed by a state-of-the-art design featuring an earthquake-resistant structure and an advanced official fire-extinguishing system, both underground and above the ground. The Prime Minister considers the new terminal to be one of the best in the world and says all the criticism and the skepticism concerning the completion of the new terminal were in vain. Foreign Minister Vartan Oskanyan, who on duty has been to almost every European airport, is greatly impressed by the new terminal, calling it a fantastic airport, better than some European airports and capable to compete with others. The minister noted that the terminal has an impressive external and internal design and will have to also have appropriate serving crew. The airport renovations are yet not complete. The finishing touches will be applied and the new terminal will commence its operation after the grand opening scheduled for May 2007.
During that same meeting at the airport, the Prime Minister also talked about the 100 Armenian citizens who remain behind bars in Georgia. The Georgian government says they are in jail because they entered the country illegally through Abkhazia and southern Ossetia from the Russian Federation.
We have told our envoys and citizens not to come and go. If the two governments have issues between them that need to be solved, we do not have to be the side that will put up with the penalty. This is an irresponsible action of our citizens, and the foreign ministry is taking the necessary steps in order to solve the issue. This has to be an example so that similar incidents would not repeat themselves in the future.
The Armenian parliament is back in session, and on the table yesterday was a proposal about regulating the parliament. Although the proposal directly concerns deputies, only a small number seem to be interested enough to attend.
On the 12th of September, the Armenian parliament was discussing National Assembly regulations, matters directly concerned with deputies, their functions and activities, but the parliament hall was almost empty. The more the society is developed, the emptier is the parliament hall, publicizes Griko Ronjeyan, also noting that this is not the case with the Armenian parliament. The emptiness of the Armenian parliament hall is not at all an index of the country's development, says Griko Ronjeyan. To cure the deputies' indifference towards obligatory summits and make them actively participate in the meetings, according to Ronjeyan, different mechanisms should be put in action. In this respect, the MAK group suggests organizing meetings twice a week to provide continuity and to assure the public that legislative bodies are permanently working. But Rafik Bedrosyan thinks it would be impossible to assemble the parliament that frequently. Another project that was put forward by the MAK group and troubled Rafik Bedrosyan was that each deputy should have an assistant paid from the state budget. Rather unexpected ideas were heard at the parliament. According to Grigor Ronjeyan, politics is a rather annoying and dull occupation for politicians and the public. But as Grigor Ronjeyan noted, it is something that the country is in need of, and persistent indifference on the side of the politicians will result in the parliament's breakdown, says Grigor Ronjeyan, bringing the example of the Russian right wing, who more frequently attended concerts, fashion shows and the similar than their responsibilities.
Free and fair elections are the subject of a debate between Armenia's various political factions. A few are proposing changes in electoral law, while others are saying the government and opposition have to have the political will to hold a fair upcoming parliamentary elections. More in this report from Armenia TV's Armen Keshishyan.
All the current discussions and projects stress that the upcoming parliamentary and presidential elections be fair and free-willed. Each party is suggesting its own method of monitoring the election procedure, and all are stressing the importance of free and fair elections. Arshar Sadoyan, the president of the National Democrats Alliance Party, and Shavarsh Kocharyan, president of the National Democratic Party, both agree. Sadoyan says the National Democrats Alliance Party has suggested a specific approach on how to ensure a fair election. Kocharyan, however, contradicts this statement, saying he hasn't seen the methodology Sadoyan is referring to. He says Sadoyan has only talked about electronic voting machines so far. Sadoyan says it would be desirable that all political parties take steps to ensure proper elections, and he says he approves of amendments to the electoral code. Kocharyan says the issue is not settled with amendments. He says the authorities and the opposition have to have the political will and desire to conduct fair elections. Kocharyan says the will is still missing. He also says that the opposition is divided, noting that it is time to put aside all types of various ambitions and differences in order to create a unified opposition. As for the question as whether or not the opposition is ready to include the Oynats Yergir party, Kocharyan states that what Oynats Yergir party does will determine whether or not the party is fit to be a part of the opposition.
The U.S. and the European Union are all going to be watching to see how Armenia fares with these elections.
And the Dashnak Tutyun also says it will extensively cooperate with other political parties in the upcoming parliamentary elections. However, the ARF says it will not form any alliances.
The parliament has recently agreed upon a resolution that guarantees and highlights the importance of fair and free-willed elections. According to the Armenian Revolutionary Federation Council member Armen Rustamyan, these are the basic conditions in order to solve the current problems and overcome obstacles that Armenia is facing. Mr. Rustamyan highlighted the main elements of the resolution, which calls on to minimize the influence of non-political elements on the political parties taking part in the elections, to reform the defaults in the electoral code, widen the span and influence of political forces in the country, increase public participation in politics, minimize the effect of voting briberies on the free will of people, and conduct legitimate elections. As for the presidential elections, whether or not the Armenian Revolutionary Federation will nominate its own candidate or support a candidate of another political faction or party will be known a year after the parliamentary elections. A lot can change after the parliamentary elections, said Armen Rustamian, stating that the party may even change its stance after the elections. Concerning the presidential elections, Mr. Rustamian stated that the prominent view of the party's participation in the elections is via a candidate of their own and they are not willing to support any other candidates. The ARF's latest conference also focused on the recent unfortunate and disgraceful events, condemning violence against journalists and calling on the government to undertake effective investigative and preventative measures to ensure the safety of individuals and the society. The party also plans to organize parliamentary hearings in order to discuss